Let me tell you how you can grow more and work less with erosion control.
We just found this area, which is perfect to talk a little bit about the pros and cons of different features and what you need to look out for. These gabions are one of the ways how we can stop erosion after a lot of water is cutting a big channel. So what we can see here in this valley, it used to cut a lot. So what they did is they built this structure, and these gabions are built in a particular way. You have these cages, so it's metal cages, and they are built in different ways. And these are filled with rocks, and they then get stacked. So you can see a little bit of the structure here. So we often have a wider base that goes all the way through, and then it gets slowly stacked on top until we have the highest point. We can clearly see the structure. So we have the wider base, and then it's going up. And this offers a lot of protection, because you can imagine it. It's a little bit like a triangular shape when it's first built. And the base here needs to hold a lot of the force. And over time, this will slowly rise and rise and rise up to this point. And where I'm standing now, this will soon all be soil, fertile topsoil, where plants can grow. And it's a perfect way to slowly regenerate this area. Placement of these features is also critical. And here we can see a massive flaw. This structure took quite a bit of time, energy, and money to build. And unfortunately, as you can probably see just above me, there is another little valley and another erosion cut. And so what happens when it rains? Water goes into this cut, it starts washing down, and here it comes with a lot of force. So it falls down, it builds a bit of a waterfall. And so in this area down there, it's washing away the base. And the base of our features, so in this case, the gabion normally of a dam wall, we always want to protect it. So it's really critical that we don't have water flow very close to it, because here we can see exactly what happens. The water is washing away the base, and it's taking away all the stability. And we can see here, these cages, these metal cages, are held in place, so they are well protected. But the problem is, the whole foundation is being washed away. So the whole foundation here is slowly disappearing. And what happens over time, even these cages won't hold. Why it's so important to attach the walls of an erosion feature really well into the sides of the valley. So here we have the low spot and water flows here. But as this feature fills up and there's a lot of water, what happens? Water flows, it flows, it flows to the side, and then boom, it starts cutting. And this is completely useless now. And that's why it's so critical that these walls are anchored very well into here and they're not just touching. This gabion is designed with the low spot just above me. And so it's designed that water accumulates in this area and then it kind of goes down like this in kind of a stepping motion. And the critical part for these features, but also for others that are designed to slow water down, is to have what is called a splash apron. So basically at the bottom, we want something where the water can hit without causing erosion. So it needs to be something really hard. Normally we build this out of lots of rocks that disperse the power of the water so it doesn't cut. The good thing is at this spot, there's bedrock. So bedrock is really hard there. The water won't cut this base away. Unfortunately here, this wasn't the case. And we can clearly see that the water has cut into the side here. And where I'm standing now is a low spot because we have the effect of a waterfall where the water is coming. Here it's crashing down, continuing. And so this cut the base away. In this particular situation, unfortunately, it's even worse. I'm currently walking in a channel that they've dug where normally, you know, having these channels that are level or almost level, they can be great to slow water down and to bring it from one spot to the next. And in this situation, all this water is arriving over here. And what does it do? It cuts right into the base on the other side of this gabion. And here we can see it really well. You know, the channel that they've built here that brings water into this valley. If this was placed just above, so if this water would arrive on the upper side, it would have been fantastic. Unfortunately, it arrives just at the base. And so like this, they created even more problems than they would have had on the other side. So this whole feature took forever to build, probably. I don't know exactly when they built it and how much energy went into it, but the longevity of this feature is very questionable. However, there's also some really good sides about it. Even though this structure might not last forever, it did a fantastic job until now. So what we can see, this wall where I'm sitting now, this used to be much higher than the valley here. But as you can see behind me, this whole valley, it filled up with sediment. So you can see this was really like a V shape. But because of the wall here, sediment slowly filled up. And this terrace is full of fertile topsoil. All of that that washed down here, it accumulated, it rose up, and this is super fertile. And these are also the perfect spots for vegetation to establish itself again. We can see here, one of the classic trees here, the canary pine trees, they are survivable when we have a fire. So it means fires can come and these ones will survive. But a lot of the other vegetation in this area, so a lot of the biodiversity, it dies in the big fires that come occasionally. And the cool thing in this area is, because we have so much fertile topsoil, this area, it has more water in it because of the gabion wall there. It slowly fills up. And here, this is going to be a prime spot for vegetation to establish itself again. So these erosion control structures, like this gabion wall, they are a little bit different to the kind of dam walls or the walls of ponds that we build in other situations, where when we're building a wall of a pond or a dam where we want to hold water, we always want to make sure that the spillway, so the overflow when the feature is full, is on the side of it. And we want to keep the wall and the spillway separate, because as we've seen in this case, water can cut away the base of it. But in this situation, it's designed to slow the water. It's not designed to hold the water forever and then have another exit. So this is designed to slow it down, to let it trickle through, so it's semi-permeable. And what we want to do in these situations is what you can see here. This part here is the exit. So this is a little bit lower than the rest of the wall. And this is a critical feature, because as the water level rises in this, we want the water to go on this side. Here we have a great example to see the low spot in the middle of this gabion wall. So water comes from that side, it can rise, and then it goes down here. So here we have quite a bit of a fall. And so compared to that other structure, this one is going to last much longer. Because as you can imagine, if we wouldn't have this feature, water would find the low spot, and it often starts cutting on the sides. So the water would rise and it would start flowing on the side of the wall. And what happens there is it cuts into the side wall, it flows around it, and the whole practicality and the whole efficiency of this feature, we lose it because the water will find the easiest path. Here we can perfectly see how the sediment build up. So here we have the exit. So this is the point where we want the water to flow. And this would be perfect. However, we can see in this part, the soil went somewhere. By not anchoring this wall far enough into the side here, water found a way to cut around and it cut this whole channel. So this feature was probably great at some point. It accumulated a lot of erosion, but because of a little bit of sloppiness in the construction, now it's useless again. That's why always when we're building these kind of features to slow erosion down, we want to have the low spot in the middle so we keep the flow centered instead of just cutting around it and making the feature useless. So it's really nice to see here. You know, you have the higher wall here, and then there in the middle we have the low spot. And yeah, as we've said before, we don't have a splash apron down there, so it's cutting the base. But this is already great designed. It's cut into the wall so that the gabion wall here is part of the site, so that the water can't flow around it. So there's a lot of great features about this. Unfortunately, as we've discussed, a few things will make the structure fail, but it did a great job. You know, we have all the sediment that didn't end up further down. Erosion was definitely slowed down. And so it's just important that when they build more of these features, that they take that into account. And if you're interested to learn more about water cycle restoration in general, different ways of holding water, of storing it in the landscape, and of all the different tools we have available, please let me know in the comments what you would like to learn next. And I will do my best to show you different options and how we can do them, the do's and don'ts, the pros and cons of all these different features, and how you can also build them yourself.